The show with a fresh perspective on classical music. Be surprised, be entertained, spin on classical music.
Hello.
And welcome to the very first episode of Spin on Classical Music. My name is Henry.
And I'm Pia.
And I am so happy to be here with you right at the Karajan Institute in Salzburg.
The capital of classical music.
That's right. So, Pia, what is Spin on Classical Music about and what can the listener expect?
With Spin on Classical Music, we want to present an easy, entertaining and sometimes surprising musical show about classical music.
Yes, exactly. And I'll promise you, and with you I mean the audience out there, that you don't need any background in classical music. Just lean back, relax and listen. So that was the very first piece in our episode.
It was Dies Irae, the Day of Wrath. It was from a Requiem from Giuseppe Verdi is the composer.
And classical music is everywhere. This is the topic of our today's episode. And what does this piece have to do with classical music is everywhere?
Classical music is everywhere. I wanted to show that by choosing popular TV shows and popular movies.
Of course.
Yeah. So we all love to watch TV shows or movies, don't we?
Movies are about life, and it shows the whole range of humanity, of experiences one could make in a lifetime. And movies are so often using classical music to express all this big range of feelings and impressions you have.
Yeah, and I think I've shown with this track list that it was used in very popular films years ago, but it's still used a lot during recent years or with very popular shows today. And this one, the Dies Irae by Verdi, it was used in several movies. For instance, The Shining. Mm. You probably know that.
Of course, I know that.
And recently it was used for a trailer for the third season of the TV show Killing Eve. You might have seen that as well.
I haven't seen it, but I definitely will.
So Killing Eve is about a British intelligence agent. Mm-hmm. She's called Eve. Mm-hmm. And she is searching for an psychopathic killer, a woman. Mm-hmm. That's something very special. So they two, they develop an obsession for each other. So I think this piece was very
fitting. It really matched the dramatic. I can see the pictures in front of my eyes in my head. Yeah.
Yeah. So the next piece is also about an assassin. Mm-hmm. The assassination of Gianni Versace, something I watched a few months ago.
So we are staying in the bloody, bloody section of movies and TV shows.
But sometimes they really use this contradiction because sometimes the scene is really dramatic, mm-hmm, and the music is very calm. Mm-hmm. So the whole series starts with this piece of music.
Mm-hmm. Curious. Thank you. this is dramatic for me.
Oh, okay.
The first one wasn't that dramatic. I didn't feel that.
It's rather aggressive, the first one.
Mm-hmm. And what do we see in the pictures?
You can see Gianni Versace waking up in his mansion in Miami, and it's a very special style he had.
Mm-hmm.
It's antique and very golden.
Mm-hmm.
And you can see him walking through his mansion and through his garden. And then they always cut it with the assassin making himself ready to kill.
And this is more dramatic because I can feel the difference between this nice music piece I'm listening to and the pictures I see, like, okay, he's preparing to kill. He's preparing to end life.
I don't know why, but I chose another piece from a very bloody movie.
Mm-hmm.
It also like have it. You also have the blood in the title. There will be blood.
Yeah, I
have
know
you
that.
Seen that one?
Yes, oh,
Daniel Day-Lewis mm-hmm. Got an Oscar for it, and I remember sitting in the movie theater, and I just started studying musicology. And right in the end, when Daniel Day-Lewis killed. He's sitting there and he's like, now I'm ready. And there's blood everywhere and this music starts. And I only realized while I was preparing this show mm-hmm. that actually an interpretation by Herbert von Karajan was chosen for the movie.
Mm-hmm. And as we do this show for the very first time, maybe we should very quickly talk a little bit about Herbert von Karajan. Who was it and why is he so special?
We are here in the Karajan Institute, mm-hmm. so obviously we have something to do with Karajan. He was a very famous conductor. He lived from 1908 till 1989,
mm-hmm.
and he was like the godfather of classical music during his time.
Mm-hmm. One could say he is classical music. He brought classical music into the masses. He not only conducted the orchestras. He built festival houses all over the world. He was very engaged in making recordings available. He was a technician. He was not only a musician and an artist. He also was very interested in bringing classical music to the people out there, to masses, to millions of people, and to foster the beauty of music.
So let's listen to this wonderful interpretation by Herbert von Karajan and the famous Anne-Sophie Mutter, a famous violinist.
Thank you.
So that was the piece from the movie There Will Be Blood. You said before that it's the piece was played at the very end.
Yes.
When he's sitting around, surrounded by blood.
Yes, and then it fades over to the
credits.
End credits.
Yeah, I can feel it. I can feel it. But I really recommend to listen to Anne-Sophie Mutter, because she is really, really exceptional and very, very good. Very energetic, fast playing, an exceptional woman.
So the next piece is from one of, I think, the most iconic TV shows of all time.
Which is
Breaking Bad.
Mm-hmm.
So you did like that, Nikolai, our producer, didn't you?
I watched it three times.
He watched it three times?
In its entirety, yeah, okay, so you really liked it.
Really, you did that?
Oh,
that's okay. That's a good TV show to watch with your grandmother. Somebody cooking crystal meth.
So, and what exactly is the next piece? Do we speak about that?
We could. It's called Faust, a ballet music from the composer Gounod. And the interesting thing about this is it's also very contradicting to the scene it was used for. So it's a very happy music. But actually, it's a very dangerous scene.
Mm-hmm.
So this is, I think, something that's very common.
And in which episode do we hear this piece?
So this was used in the final when Walt is sitting in the house of his former business partners, Gretchen and Elliot. And actually, they don't notice him. He's standing in the background all the time and they don't see him.
Mm-hmm.
So you can tell that this is really a contradiction between the music and what is going to happen. So let's listen to it.
Yeah, let's listen to it. And I have to admit that I never have seen Breaking Bad. So actually,
that's like a knowledge gap.
Yeah.
Do you say that in English?
Yeah, you can say. I know what you mean. And I would say this is the next TV show I will have to add to my watch list. So thank
yes.
you. Thank you for that tip, Pia.
Yeah. Let me show you something iconic. What's
a little bit scared.
What's more iconic than Star Wars?
Oh, please. Yeah, I love it. I love it. So
you're a big fan, aren't you?
I think I'm probably the biggest fan of Star Wars. I have every movie, every side movie. How is it called? It's they were so
behind the scenes.
Behind the scenes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I have everything. I have it.
Okay.
In 3D, by the way. I'm still having a 3D player at home, and I have all the Star Wars movies in 3D.
Really?
Yes. And my whole family is sitting in front of the TV, and we have
you
these
show this to your little children?
Yes, I do. And they also love it. And we are all sitting with these nerdy glasses, 3D glasses, in front of our TVs. And
yeah.
I can show you some really funny pictures.
So the soundtrack of Star Wars, of all the Star Wars movies, was composed by John Williams.
Mm-hmm.
But he borrowed something from another composer, Gustav Holst.
Mm-hmm. So he recomposed the
or
original
let's say
piece.
Like a lot of composers do, he took some inspiration
mm-hmm.
from another piece of classical
That's how
music.
It's called. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and actually, it's called The Planets, so you realize why he took it. And this piece is was used for the Imperial March, the
mm-hmm.
Darth Vader theme, and Gustav Holst he called it Mars, so the god of war. So talking about big pictures or iconic pictures, I mean, John Williams for Star Wars, he borrowed a lot of classical music,
mm-hmm.
but then there was another movie already in the 60s, 2001, Space Odyssey,
mm-hmm.
very famous movie.
Mm-hmm.
And for this, a whole soundtrack was composed already. And then Stanley Kubrick said, no, I don't like it.
Really?
But the interesting thing about this film is that it looks so modern. Have you watched it?
Yes, I did. Mm-hmm. I can remember, yeah.
Yeah.
It wasn't like watching a movie from the 60s.
Yeah, that's true. Very innovative in the way it was filmed.
Like and it was with Star Wars.
Yeah, that's true.
In the 70s.
And somehow I also really, I think that's also because he left this classical music as it is. So that's really a great contrast with
mm-hmm.
this modern picture. So I think that's also part of why it still looks so modern. A lot of us know the beginning with the Richard Strauss, Also sprach Zarathustra. Mm-hmm. And but there's another scene with the Donau waltz in the middle where you can see the ship mm-hmm. from all sides. Mm-hmm. And I thought, as we are now recording in Salzburg in Austria, I thought that this would be the perfect ending to the first episode to mm-hmm. have a Johann Strauss, an Austrian waltz at the end.
So let me suggest that we are coming to an end and we are listening now to the last piece of our today's episode, which is
the Danube Waltz, the secret anthem of Austria. And we will be back next month with another episode called Wave of Emotions.
Sounds good, and I'm really looking forward to it. Goodbye, Pia.
Bye-bye.